Who'd you expect, John Foster Dulles or somebody?
Would you like to,
Do you mind if I have a smoke, Agatha?
Why don't you live modern? Why don't you live?
Hey, how about that backdrop?
You like it?
Wowie, and a ring-a-ding-ding, and a ring-dang-dung.
And a ka-ding-dong.
Ka-ding-dong-dung.
My heart goes ding-dong-ding. When I'm near you, it goes ding-dong-ding. Cause I need you, it goes ding-dong-ding. Cause I love you, it goes ding-dong. Ding-dong.
You know I love you, Frankie boy. And if you kiss me, it will fill me with joy.
All around my heart, where the feeling is, it goes ka-ding.
Who will present the 1957 Chevrolet on Friday, October 19th. Bring you live from Hollywood, The Chevy Show. Tonight, starring Miss Dinah Shore, with her guests, Dizzy Dean, the Skylarks, and special added attraction, Frank Sinatra. And now, here is the star of our show, Miss Dinah Shore.
Hey, this must be the place.
Oh, yes, pretty.
If it ain't the place, where is the place?
It isn't the place, and it's fancier than last time.
Oh, I remember. It's quite much fancier than it was.
Remember that? WNEW, New York.
Yeah, we were on the wireless then.
Oh, make it sound like radio.
Radio.
It was at least 5-6 years ago.
Yep, 56 years ago, exactly. Right to the day.
Whatever it was, I want you to remember I was 8 years old at the time.
Yeah, you know you haven't changed a bit.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You've been taking good care of yourself, too.
You look so pretty.
Do I?
Yes, you do.
I'd say you look
I've been
pretty,
taking care of myself,
me.
Too. What?
I said, I'd say you look pretty, too, but you'd hit me.
No, I never do that.
You look good.
I do. I feel great.
You owe it all to something.
I owe it all to weightlifting.
Yeah. And it shows.
It
you
do?
Know, oh, yeah. You've been making some wonderful records.
Well, that's even tougher than lifting weights because pressing those machines is murder,
you see.
You gotta...
I know it. It's your own fault, though. If you didn't sell so many, you wouldn't have to press so many.
Oh, you're just saying that because it's not true.
It is. Ladies and gentlemen, here's one that's gonna keep him pressing for a month.
Oh. Anybody got any old coats and thing want pressed? Just send them over. I'll press them off for you.
The muscles when you get through with this one. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time on television, here's Frank Sinatra singing his new Capitol recording. Hey, jealous lover.
Look out now. Jealous lover, you're acting so strange. Hey, jealous lover, what is making you change? Hey, jealous lover, how wrong can you be? I'm yours ever faithful, so be faithful to me. Maybe you're accusing me of what I'm doing yourself. Hey, jealous lover, I'm telling you true. I know that you're jealous, but there's no one but you. I clock, the clock that sits on the shelf. And maybe you're accusing me of what you do in yourself, a jealous lover. I'm telling you true, I know that you're jealous, but there's no one but you. There's no one for me, jealous love, but you.
Great. All right.
Ah. Fooled you, didn't I? Oh, I'm sneaky tonight, sneaky.
I like everything you do.
You have got good taste.
Oh, I don't know.
Say, what's the coat bit and where are we going?
Well, I'm going to pick up Dizzy Dean. You're going to stay here and mind the store.
You're going to pick him up?
That's right.
I guess this fella still knows a little be something beside baseball.
Oh, don't be silly. He's just a big country boy.
I know, but so was George Montgomery. All I know is that he's getting better treatment than I got.
Oh, you know your way around the city, boy.
Yeah, it's true, but you know this guy's so wonderful. Well, he knows his way around a ball field. He's been my idol ever since I was knee-high to Rocky Carr.
Yeah?
Yeah. That's a local joke. We're not one of the show.
Got a lot of laughs in the studio.
Sure.
Haven't you ever met him?
No, I've never met Dizzy. Say, do you think maybe he'd autograph a baseball for me?
If you've been a good boy.
Well, it would have been nice.
Frankie, we're going to be back before you can say Jackie Robinson.
Oh, don't you.
As he flew it in the third. As he slid into third. Hey, Leo, how do you spell third? Slid.
Yes, master.
Slud, how do you spell it?
Slud?
Yes.
Oh, we slud. As in, he slud on a banana peel.
That's right.
S-L-Ud.
Thank you. I don't know what in the world I'd do without you.
Oh, Monsieur Dizzy, Mademoiselle Shore has just arrived. She wishes to escort you to NBC.
Show her in, partner. S-L-Ud.
Now is the time for all good men to come to the aid of the Yankees.
Welcome to the Dean's Den, Miss Dinah.
Well, I'm glad to be here. Are you ready to go?
Well, I reckon, but I'll guarantee you one thing. I got the sweats.
Dizzy!
I'm sorry, Miss Dinah. I'm inclined to hypertension when faced with unfamiliar situations.
You mean you get the sweats? Don't you worry about it, Dizzy, because you're going to be just fine.
You got my words all wrote out for me?
Oh, we're just going to talk about baseball. Nobody has to write that for you.
Well, I was afraid you might ask me to sing.
Uh-huh.
And the only thing I do is the Wabash Cannonball.
I can sing something besides a Wabash Cannonball.
Well, maybe them eyes of Texas.
Yeah, them. Dizzy, how'd you like today's game?
Well, it was quite a ball game out there today for the Brooklyn Dodgers. I know the Yankees lost a second ball game of the series, Dinah,
yeah.
And it's one of those things that, in fact, it's the first time the Yankees have ever lost two games in a World Series in a row.
Really?
That's right.
I didn't know that.
And, you know, the pitchers was very wild today. As we say in baseball, it was a little sloppy.
Yeah, we say that in television, too.
That's right. But anyway, this year, the Brooklyn Dodgers got a good edge now. There's no question about it. And there was a lot of hitting in that series.
Well,
the pitching was very bad.
I said this was going to be a hitting series. I said that.
Well, you certainly know what you was talking about. Yeah. And it certainly has been that way so far.
So much.
But you know the hit today that really was a big blow was the guy that just Yogi Berra hit with four men on base.
Four men? Hey, even I know there are only three men on a base, Dizzy. I know that.
Well, anyway, he hit the ball over the right field wall for a home run 296 feet from home plate.
297 feet from home plate. I don't know anything about baseball. It's 297 feet.
And actually, you're right. I just happen to think you're right. Absolutely right. But anyway, when Yogi hit that ball over the fence with the three on, as you say, he got Mr. Newcomb out of quite a jam.
Yeah, I'd say he cleaned the place for him.
That's right. Well, you know, tomorrow's another ball game, Dinah, and the Sears moves over to the Yankee Stadium, and the starting pitcher over there on the stand is going to be Whitey Ford.
Whitey Chevrolet.
Here. Give me a little of that there, Aparicio.
Aparicio. Shortstop for the White Sox. I know that.
I bet you don't know the Wabash Cannonball.
Who does he play for?
From out the wide Pacific to the broad Atlantic shore, she climbs the highest mountains uphill and by
Sing
the
it,
shore.
Dizzy.
She's mighty tall and handsome. She's known quite well by all. She's a combination of a Wabash Cannonball. Listen to the jingles and the rumble and the roar. As she glides along the woodlands to the hills and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engine, hear the lonesome hobo's call. As she travels one little drunk along the Wabash Cannonball. You know, Miss Dinah, I'd certainly appreciate you coming here and helping me a little bit with this.
Oh, you don't need any help, but I do have a version of my own.
And I could certainly use it, too.
No.
From out the wide Pacific,
across the great divide,
she climbs the highest mountain.
She uses power glide.
She's mighty low and handsome,
the fastest one of all.
She's sweet and smooth and sassy as the Wabash Cannonball. Listen to the jingle,
that's the dough you'll say.
As she glides along the woodland,
you'll hear the people ring.
Hear the mighty rush of the engine,
got the fastest getaway.
A gem from top to bottom is the Wabash Chevrolet.
Thank you. Your Chevrolet dealer presents an exclusive interview with the celebrated French actor, Fernandel.
Monsieur Fernandel, the 57 Chevrolet is coming Friday, October 19th. You've heard about its daring new design.
Oui. La nouvelle Chevrolet, elle est formidable.
Translation, the 57 Chevy's the most. Now, Monsieur Fernandel, what have you heard about the performance of the new Chevy?
La performance Chevrolet, elle est sensationnelle. Mm.
Translation, the 57 Chevrolet goes them all one better. So go to your Chevrolet dealer Friday, October 19. That's when you'll see the different, daring 57 Chevrolet.
He will not always say you would have him say, but now and then you'll say something wonderful. The thoughtless things he'll do will hurt and worry you, but now and then he'll do a thousand dreams that won't come true. You know that he believes in them, and that's enough for you. You'll always go along, defend him when he's wrong, and tell him
one.
for you and you didn't even listen. You didn't even listen to me.
Yes, I did, and I'd buy it, too.
Would you buy it if I recorded it?
You're doggone tootin'.
Well, that's very nice. What are you going to ask for when you get in the store?
That's what I like about the South.
That's what I thought. It was called Something Wonderful.
A fair song, but it wasn't no Wabash Cannonball.
Yeah. What is this book you're reading?
Well, that's a little thing was wrote by a down home boy.
A home downtown home boy.
My, Miss Dinah, you talk funny.
I do. My language has suffered a little in the last week, but I think I'll get it back. Let me see that. The Plays of Tennessee Williams.
You know Tennessee?
Sure. Know him. I knowed him since he was a tadpole in Little League. Used to call himself Tennessee Ernie.
Switch hitter.
Batted 265.
Hey, how about you reading baseball scores?
Well, how about you reading Tennessee Williams?
Well, I got to see what the competition is doing.
Competition? You mean you've written a play?
Sure thing.
Well, will wonders never cease?
That's right. Will wonders never cease? A play in 9 innings by Dizzy Dean.
That's the title?
It used to have another name till I read Tennessee's little story called Cat on a Hot Tin Roof.
And you had the same title.
Almost. Mine was called Dog on a Hot Cross Bun. music. You want to hear it?
No.
Well, the thing starts with me standing in front of the dugout, talking at the folks. How do you like it so far?
Well, let's put it this way. I can't wait to hear the music.
Well, I'm coming to that. Anyway, I start right off saying, fans, this here is one of them psychology dramas. It's all about a gal, a fella, a river, and a showboat.
Yeah.
And now this fella, he's a riverboat gambler, known as Raviola. Rocky Raviola. And the Roxy is plum calf-eyed over Magnolia. Yeah. She's the gal.
Oh. Hey, you know I got a great... Why don't you call this thing Showboat?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now, Magnolia, she don't love Rocky. She loves the boat. Yeah. That's the psychology part. But this ain't no ordinary boat.
No, sir.
This here is the best cotton-picking boat in Dallas.
Hey, Dizzy, wait a minute. You know there's no water anywhere near Dallas.
You see, this here boat is in dry dock.
Oh, I see. I got the whole...
Well, thing. One darn thing and another happens, and Captain Dizzy...
Who's he?
That's me.
That's...
Well, anyway, he loses the boat to Raviola. And winds up pitching for the St. Louis Cardinals. And that's a kind of an interesting way to get into the story of my life.
Well, do you have anybody in mind to play the part of Dizzy Dean?
Well, he's got to sing and he's got to be an actor.
Yeah. How about Elvis Presley?
Not that kind of an actor.
No. I got a great idea. Wait a minute. Hey, Frank! Here we are. We're so fast.
Man, that's a long walk from the bullpen back there.
Hey, Frank, I want you to meet Dizzy D.
Hi, partner.
I do, sir. Would you like to autograph my baseball?
Be a pleasure, son. What's your name?
Just make it out to Frank.
Hey, Frank, Dizzy's looking for somebody to play the story, in the lead in the story of his life, and, gee, knowing you are such a Dizzy fan... Knowing you are such a Dizzy fan...
That's an improvement. Say, that's pretty good, eh?
Say, not bad. Not bad at all. Now tell me this. Who holds the highest batting average for any single player in the major leagues?
Rogers Hornsby.
All right, on to the next plateau. Can you dance?
Yeah, I can dance a little, but I don't know what...
Okay, Professor. A little slap time music, partner. Son, let's see you stomp around
a little
bit here.
Stomp around a little bit, honey. Go on.
Stomp around a little bit. Thank you.
Frank. You see, he...
Don't apologize for the boy. He ain't much on his feet, but I'll say one thing for you, partner. You got a lot of nerve.
He's got a lot of nerve.
Well, Dinah, you got a lot of nerve, too.
Gee, Diz, I hate to let you down, but I'm sorry.
Oh, ain't struck out yet. You ever done any play acting?
Well, I've done a few walk-ons, yeah.
Oh, come on, Diz. Look, this has gone far enough. You don't seem to realize this is Frank Sinatra you're talking to.
Honey, I don't care if he's Joe DiMaggio. I gotta know, can he act?
All right, we'll just have to show him. Frank, give him just a little bit of that death scene from Here to Eternity. Just a little.
Oh, this will bring back silent pictures.
Go on.
I don't need your help, Diz. You just hang on me right here. See, now you play Pruitt, and I'm Maggio, and I'm about ready to conk out.
Yeah?
Yeah, and I say, Prue, it was Fatso who done it. Watch out for Fatso. He done it.
This guy here ain't well.
I've been sick.
He's been very sick. Are you satisfied now?
Well, almost, but that wouldn't win no Academy Award. Too bad he don't sing.
Well, I'm sorry, Dizzy, but I guess I just can't play the be in your play. I just can't do it, I guess.
Well, son, don't fret. We'll do like they did in the Al Jolson picture. We'll use your... you wiggle your mouth, and we'll use my voice.
Will you listen to me, Dizzy?
I don't have to, child. I know you can sing.
Congratulations.
I made it.
Sing, girl.
Singer. I'll sing.
Girl, singer.
£1 of rocks from Cartier's, one dozen Meeks, 10 Chevrolets, a wagon load of bonds and stocks, then open up the door to Fort Knox and throw me
smack dab in the middle.
Sing it, Dick.
Smack dab in the middle. Smack dab in the middle. Let me rock and roll to satisfy my soul.
Hey, how about you, Frank? Anything in life you want, you haven't got?
Yeah, but take too long. One pair of twins about your size. One not too dumb and one not wise. One gal to cook and one gal to sew. And if they walk like Marilyn Monroe,
hey,
then throw me smack dab in the middle.
If you had anything to wish for, what would it be?
Yeah, a pitching arm.
Uh-huh.
That won't go sore.
Yeah.
The speed I had in 34. My dusty glove.
You got it.
My rusty spikes. My brother Paul a calling balls and strikes.
Hey!
Smack dab in the middle.
It's a me.
Smack dab dab in the middle.
Fling
a bit. Smack dab.
Hello there. Tonight I'd like you to join me in a short visit to someone you probably know. The person in question, your franchised Chevrolet dealer. And just what is a typical Chevrolet dealer doing about this time? Well, it's more than likely that he's working. Busier than ever. For while this is October for you and me, it's the end of the year for him. It's been nearly 12 months since the lively, lovely 56 Chevy was first introduced. So now he's taking inventory, checking his total sales of a truly record-breaking car. And as he reviews the past year, he has much to be grateful about. He's sold a lot of cars, far more than anyone else. And he's made a lot of friends. Friends he'll keep because he treated them right. But as reminiscing takes in more than dollars and cents, He remembers how glad he was to join in community activities, to serve on various local committees. And he remembers with real pleasure his co-sponsorship of the Soapbox Derby. Over 60,000 boys took part this year, and last August, the 19th annual Soapbox Derby finals were held at Akron, Ohio, with 155 boys competing for thousands of dollars worth of college scholarships and valuable prizes. His participation in the Soapbox Derby is close to his heart, as is the part he plays in the important program of driver training. With other franchised Chevrolet dealers, he's furnished over 3,500 cars to high schools throughout the country. And he can't help but feel proud that his continuing efforts on behalf of highway safety have won many national awards. It's been a good year on every count for your franchised Chevrolet dealer. And after he's closed the books for 1956, he's ready to move into high gear again. For he has a hunch that 57 is going to be even better. So one of the first things he does is to reserve places for the new 1957 Chevrolet coming Friday, October 19th. And in his mind's eye, he sees it right now. The entire showroom decorated to catch the thrill and excitement of this great new automobile. Perhaps over there you'll place the sleek new 1957 Chevrolet convertible. And then for the main attraction, one of Chevrolet's new 1957 sports sedans, a hardtop with a daring departure in design. Yes, as he starts for home, he's a happy man because he knows that once again, he can offer you a car that's the finest car in the low price field. So as soon as you can, see your franchise Chevrolet dealer. You like him, and he'll enjoy meeting you. So as soon as you can, or on Friday, October 19th, see your franchise Chevrolet dealer, who'll proudly show you the new 1957 Chevrolet.
Hey, Frank, you promised me whatever you do that you won't buy any car until October 19th and you can see the brand new Chevrolet, you promised?
Who's got the money to buy a car before October 19th?
You promised.
I promised the Scouts on it.
Oh, good boy. You having fun?
I'm having a ball.
Oh, I'm glad.
A little warm, but it's fun.
Oh, yeah. Gosh, just like the old days.
Yeah, the old days.
Remember?
What old days?
Don't you remember the early show we used to do on WNEW?
Do I? Every time I think about them, I get tired.
Yeah.
Imagine having to sing love songs at 6 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, yeah.
And not even finishing the chorus. There was never enough time.
All the emotion into it.
Yeah.
Gee whiz. Well, in a way, we were lucky, though, because they used to give us free coffee.
Yeah.
And who could afford breakfast in those days?
Yeah. And it's the same coffee.
I got the same cigarette butts.
Same cigarette butts in mine.
Hey, you remember Jimmy Rich?
Yeah, one-man band.
Oh, darling.
And a great
fellow.
Buddy.
I'll say. Vocal coach, arranger, big brother.
And how about the announcer, the little guy with the big voice? Used to do this bit
every
all the
morning.
Time.
Yeah.
How did we used to start the program?
Fighting over who was going to sing the ballad.
Oh, I remember how we started.
How?
Let me see. Where's the part?
Here we are, out of cigarettes. Holding hands and yawning, look how late it gets. Two sleepy people by dawn's early light, and too much in love to say goodnight.
Good morning. It's time to greet the new day in the very best way with our two sweethearts of song, Miss Dinah Shore. And Frank Sinatra.
By dawn's early light.
And too much in love to say goodnight.
True romance is a happy and gay thing. Especially for our two young lovers as they musically ask these tender questions.
Do you remember one September afternoon?
I stood with you and listened to a wedding tune.
And didn't I go with you on your honeymoon?
remember me.
Do you recall a kite small upon a hill?
Where every day I had to pay another bill. And if I'm not mistaken, dear, I pay them still. Remember me.
I can see that little angel on your knee.
Can't you see? He kinda sorta looks like me. For I'm the boy whose only joy is loving you.
I worry till you hurry home when day is through.
And I'm the guy I give your goodnight kisses to. Remember me.
You know, it was really like that.
Yeah, fight,
the early
fight,
morning
fight.
Throats.
Then on to bigger and better things, huh?
Yeah, and bigger and better salaries and orchestras and better hours.
Yeah, you went with Tommy Dorsey's band and I went with Eddie Cantor's band.
Eddie Cantor?
Band.
Oh, yes, I sure got my kicks, though, singing with that swinging rhythm section.
You still swinging, boy.
Yeah, and you've been doing a few toe tappers yourself.
Shall we?
We are already.
All right.
You make me feel so young. You make me feel that spring has sprung. And every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual.
I fell in love with you first time I looked into you. Then my eyes, you've got a certain cute way. Oh, they make me feel happy. They make me blue. No stalling, I'm falling, falling in a great big way for you.
A foggy day in London town had me low, and it had me down. And in foggy London town, the sun was shining, shining, shining everywhere.
Got you under my skin.
Bop.
I've got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart.
Come on, join us, it's fun.
I hear those trumpets wail again. I am all aglow again, taking a chance on love. Things are mending now. I see a rainbow blending now. We'll have our happy ending now, taking a chance on love.
The memory of all that.
Sing it, pretty guy.
No, no, they can't take that away from me. The way you hold your knife.
Oh, very big one.
The way we did it. The way you changed my life. No, no, they can't take that away.
Not from with me around.
No.
Of me.
Wow.
Why not take all of me? Can't you see me? I'm just a mess without.
little child.
When you were only starting to go to kindergarten, I bet you drove the little boys wild.
And when it came to winning blue ribbon,
I was in every get kennel contest.
You showed the other kids how.
I got a room full, I can see the judge's eyes as they handed you the prize. I bet you made the cutest bow.
You must have been a beautiful baby.
You sure got a lot of nerve. Your game.
Oh, I'm brave. You know, Frank, in all the years we've known each other and we've sung together, we've only made one recording together.
Yeah.
Isn't that funny?
It's very strange, but you think we ought to do it for the folks now?
Let's do. Should we?
All right, after you.
No, you accompany.
Okay.
I'm discontented with homes that are rented, so I have invented my own.
Is a lover's oasis where life's weary chase is unknown.
Far from the cry of the city where flowers pretty caress the stream. Cozy to hide in, to live side by side in. Don't let it abide in your dreams.
Picture me upon your knee, tifa too and tupa tee.
Me for you and you for me alone.
Oops, we got company.
Nobody near us to see us. Hear us, no friends or relations on weekend vacations. We won't have it known, dear. We own a telephone. Shall we?
Such a long, long
October 19th, because that's the day it comes our way. The new 57 Chevrolet. Like such a long, long time till Friday, October 19th. Hurry up, you clocks, what makes you tick so slow? If you knew how great the Chevy is, you'd get up and go. Seems a long time till it goes on display, the new 57 Chevrolet, Friday, October 19th. Friday, October 19th.
You'll see what I mean. Friday, October 19th at your Chevrolet dealer. The time has come for us to go. We hope that you enjoyed our show. Before we leave, I'd like to my Uncle Dizzy Dean and Brother Frank for squeezing me.
Smack dab in the middle. Smack dab in the middle. Smack dab in the middle.
The Chevy Show has been brought to you by your authorized Chevrolet dealer, who invites you to see the 1957 Chevrolet Friday, October 19th. Featured in tonight's cast was Johnny Silver. And on October 21st, the Chevy Show will star Bob Hope with his guests Desi Arnaz, Lucille Ball, Diana Dors, and James Cagney. Your Chevrolet dealer also brings you the Dinah Shore Show every Thursday over this network, and Crossroads, exciting stories based on the...